One day Baba was sitting in the room, and meanwhile Dr. The son entered in the room, and Baba knew everything about everybody. So he told Dasarath, you want to know me? What is my real form? He was thinking to know about him. But you cannot know me without my grace. You cannot. You can know me with my grace. As you have intense desire to know about me, so see me. So Baba was sitting on the cot. He was sitting just in front of Baba. Then what he saw, Baba's physical body was disappeared. Where Baba was sitting, there was only mass of light. Effulgent light was there, white light. And while seeing that effulgent light, he was getting tremendous happiness. And there was sound coming from the effulgent light. Kalyanamastu, Suhamastu, Kalyanamastu, Suhamastu. And while seeing the effulgent light, he was getting immense happiness. His mind was completely engrossed in the happiness. Then Baba told, you know, this is my reality. I have no physical form. So God is effulgent light, is a divine entity. And one can realize about him through his grace. So Baba got him realized that Anandamurti is not a physical phenomenon. He is a spiritual entity, additional entity. So likewise, as I have desired to know, since very beginning I developed the physical intimacy with him. When I was with him alone in his room, I was always gazing at him with an intense concentrated mind. Just I was looking at him with a concentrated mind. So Baba was asking, why you are looking at me with the intense eyes, with the concentrated eyes? What you are looking, it is a physical body. It is not a Anandamurti, it is not your guru. So sometimes I was getting confused, why Baba is telling like that? This body, physical body, is not a Anandamurti, then what is Anandamurti? Because I am getting a lot of bliss, happiness through this body. I am listening many good things through this body. So I was considering this body as a guru. So whenever I was alone in the room of Baba, I was always looking at him with a concentrated eye. And he was telling, this body is not guru. If you want to realize guru, then just he was teaching my race, Sahasra Chakra, Guru Chakra. Concentrate your mind. When I was concentrating my mind here at the Guru Chakra, I was getting a lot of happiness, immense happiness, which I cannot describe. So what you are seeing, that is your real Guru. So Anandamurti is the embodiment of bliss. And you can have a realization about him through your deeper meditation. But I have so much attachment with the physical body. Once Baba told, if you will have so much physical attachment, then you will be in the problem. But he created his divine play. I had so much attachment with the body. He created so much repulsion for that body, his physical body. A time came, then even while seeing his physical body, I could not, I was getting repulsive attitude, repulsion. Sometime when I was doing dhyana, then he was meeting with his stick and shouting and screaming, you know, I was afraid of, even I was not able to do dhyana. But at the same time, I had a much inner love for him. But externally, I got repulsion for his physical body. I was confused, what is Anandamurti? I cried for 4 months. And it is very difficult when you have some confusion about your guru. If you have some repulsive attitude. Even I had developed hatredness to the physical body of the Guru. That was very painful for me. I cried and cried to Baba. If you are not physical body, then what you are? So after 4 months, he gave this demonstration, which I am going to tell you. There was the 18th time, 4th January. He came in the room. Entire room was spiritually vibrated. Maybe 14 devotees were sitting in the small room. Tightly they were sitting. He gave some very nice talk about devotion. And we felt that in a room there was dizzling light was floating in the room. And all devotees were spiritually vibrated. Meanwhile, he took my name and called me, "You come closer in front of me." Accordingly, I came and sat in front of Baba. Then he touched my Agya Chakra, gave divine vision. Then he told me that I should concentrate my mind very deeply in Sahasra Chakra, Guru Chakra, and I should do Dhyana. So if we do this 6 lesson, those who have got 6 lesson, they might be knowing how we do 6 lesson. I started doing Dhyana. When I started doing Dhyana, then that day I had a very frightening experiences, very scary experiences. I felt that the Guru's physical body is dissolving. He is decaying, he is dying. So I had never that type of feeling that his physical body is dying. So I had a lot of fear. Then Baba told me, "Don't get afraid. Go still more in the deeper meditation, in deeper dhyana." The moment Baba told that, "Don't get afraid. Let you should go in the more deeper meditation." Automatically my mind was deeply concentrated. Then he told in front of everybody, "Whatever you have realization, you should reveal in the front of everyone." So when he told me that I should have deep concentration in my Guru Chakra, Sahasra Chakra, then I had a very bright feeling. I could see that mass of light is floating over my Sahasra Chakra. And while seeing the divine light, I started feeling intense happiness, which I cannot describe. Then Baba told, "What you are having this realization or feeling in Sahasra Chakra?" Then Baba told for the third time, "If still you go more in the deeper dhyana." The moment he told, my mind became very, very concentrated. Then he told, "Now you see what you are seeing." Then I told in front of everybody, "Baba, I am seeing that effulgent light is, bright light is floating over my Sahasra Chakra. And on that bright light, you are sitting in a Varaha Mudra, but not in the body of flesh and bone. You are sitting in the body of white effulgent." He was in the effulgent from form, but not in the body of flesh and bone. His entire figure was in the effulgent light, but he was in the figure of Varaha Mudra. And after realizing, visualizing that divine experiences, I started getting immense happiness, divine happiness. Then Baba told, "What he is having realization, what he is visualizing, that is the real form of Anandamurti." Then Baba told, "Anandamurti is not a physical phenomena. He is not a physical body. He is a spiritual entity. He is an additional entity. his divine life. Yet he is Anandamurti, embodiment of bliss. So there is no sinner, no virtue.